earth to teach and to demonstrate the supernatural with miracles, signs, and wonders. God doesn't change. God is supernatural. Apostle Guillermo Maldonado is called to bring God's supernatural power to this generation. For over 25 years, he has been teaching and activating believers from around the world to do the same. Get ready to receive your miracle today and allow God to use you to demonstrate his power here and now. This is a reality you can experience in your life today. Join us as we see more of the supernatural now.
Welcome all the people that are watching by television, and I want to welcome all the people that are watching by the internet. I want to welcome you, and I'm speaking about the second coming of Jesus. So today I'm going to speak to you the signs of the end time. So now I'm going to talk to you about the signs of the end time, which is different. The sign of his coming is the preaching of the gospel. When this gospel is being preached all over the nations, then the end will come. Now, the second thing is there's a difference between the sign of his coming and the signs of the end time. A sign is a reality that points to higher reality. A sign never ended in the sign. Always point to something. Whenever you just saw the four red moon, did you hear that? Did you see that? Okay, that was a sign in heaven. What is it saying? It's not about the moon that was red. Oh my God, it was red. No, it's pointing to higher reality. And I'm going to say this. Every sign of God points back to God. There's a difference between a miracle, a sign, and a wonder. Many people confuse those three things. A sign, a sovereign act of God. A sign is given to you, is given to me, or is given to a nation. A miracle is done for God through us. A sign is God's initiative to you and to me. When you saw the red moon, God is saying something to humanity. I am saying that I'm coming back soon. I am saying, and I use the feast of God to say how God speaks through the feast of God. Not a feast of Israel, I'm saying the feast of God. So what I'm saying to you is sign always is a reality that points to higher reality. That's why, as a believer, we don't follow signs. Signs follow us. Mark 16:15. These signs shall follow those who believe. Now, God is giving signs. Where will be the signs of the end time, of the world, of the age as we know it? Number one, he said in Matthew 24:4. And Jesus answered to them, take heed that no one deceives you. That was the first sign. Now, we will be back into that sign because there's only one sign that Jesus mentioned three times. He didn't mention earthquakes three times. He didn't mention offense three times. This is the only one that he mentioned three times. That tells you it's very dangerous. Deception, lie. And then verse 5, for many will come in my name saying, I am the Christ, and will deceive many. He mentioned deception again. He went from you to many. Verse 4, take heed that no one deceive you. Verse 5. And they will deceive. So it goes from you to many. From singular to plural. What is it saying? Many will be deceived. First, be careful with you. And then he said, be careful even with your own family. And many will be deceived. And then, listen, and then verse 24, you will see that he mentioned the same thing again. For false Christs and false prophets will rise and show great signs and wonders, if possible, even the elect. It goes from you to many to, if possible, even the elect. Well, who are the elect? You, the believers, the Christians. So in other words, the spirit of deception is within the church now. And Jesus is warning you, the end, the sign, one of the signs of the end time is the deception, is the spirit of lie, deception in the church. And then he says, be careful, you. And then many. And then he said, if it's possible, the elected. Okay, number three, wars and rumors of wars. Wars are always based on economy. They are used to reset. They use wars to reset economy. Every war has to be paid, and after the war is over, we leave a deficit in the country. So, number four, it will raise up a nation against nation 24/7. For a nation will rise against nation, and a kingdom against kingdom, and it will be famines and pestilence and earthquakes in various places. In that particular verse tells me more of the signs. The word nation is the word ethnos. It's not like we see now, United States against Iraq or against Russia, but the word nation here is different. The word nation is the word ethnos, and the word ethnos is where ethnicity comes from. And to say it in modern terms will be race. In other words, Jesus said, you will see racism increase in the end time.
God's supernatural power is a reality. Witness his love in action as he continues to transform the lives of countless people around the world, bringing change, deliverance, healing, and miracles of all kinds. Believe for a miracle in your life today.
When I was born, I was missing half of my brain.
Were missing half of your brain?
I was 2 pounds, so I had to be carrying a pillow. My mom and my family would always fight back and forth who's gonna take care of me forever.
Because my whole life, because of the way I was being treated, not only by the people at school, not only by what the government said or my family told me, but I got addicted to drugs, I got addicted to fighting. When I came to a fighting service, the Apostle Maldonado was preaching, and I decided to go to the front for the first time in my life.
I remember you was preaching about healing and everything and about financial and job. And I told God, I want to be a man of my own. I want to stand up in my feet and prove to my family that I'm not worthless. And I'm like, God, you know what? For today, for my first time, I'm going to go up to the front and I'm going to ask you for your help. And when I did, I felt this fire over me. I thought I had this headache. I'm like, God, what's going on? And then the next day I go to the doctor. The doctor tells me, hey, guess what? I'm like, what? You're allowed to get a job. You're allowed to go back to school. You're allowed to do anything you want now.
But because of the glory of God, I don't know how to explain it to you. I don't know if the doctor would ever explain it to you, because the way my life has changed, the people around me seeing how much I changed, the family started to believe more in God because of what happened in my life. And I tell you, parents, because of your kids being mentally challenged, it's not true. The devil is a liar. Because I'm a walking proof to tell the devil enough is enough. Because if I, who was mentally challenged, I'm regular, supernaturalist, man walking, you could do the same thing.
I lacked a lot in my marriage. I lacked a lot as a man. There was many things that I didn't know how to do. She would have to do it for me. And I was in a position where I didn't know who I was as a man. When I came from the world, all of the stuff that I had in the world, I brought it to my marriage. And I didn't know how to separate it. The fact that I didn't have a father that could teach me how to be a man, It affected me a lot.
Growing up, I saw my dad abuse my mom abused my dad, domestic violence, cops in my house all the time. It was, to me, that was what a marriage was. And we were taking the same thing onto our marriage.
Since I didn't have that example in my house, I pulled her hair, I one time hit her, I would lay hands on her because I saw my father did it, and I was being less of a man by laying my hands on her.
There was one time where I got a knife and he pulled me from my hair. I stabbed him, I sliced his hand, and I saw blood everywhere. I couldn't believe I just cut him. I was in shock. I couldn't believe that it had gotten to that point. I realized either we change or we're gonna end up killing each other or we're gonna end up in a divorce. And that's when I realized that I needed to change.
I got a word one time. Pastor spoke to me about how the devil was attacking my marriage. When he released that word to me, it made me realize that the devil was there trying to sneak into my marriage. When I received that word and God spoke that word to me, I received it and I changed. Through the preachings and through conferences, I learned how to be a man. I learned that there's things that I need to do. I'm here to be the man to lead, be the man that moves forward, be the man that shows the example in my house.
I remember one time that one of the leaders in the church, she came up to me and she prayed for me. And she told me something about my marriage that we were dealing with. And she said, divorce is not an option. It's not gonna happen. Right there at that moment, I got set free from that fear of divorce, from that fear of losing my marriage, from that fear that it wasn't gonna work. And it wasn't until God had delivered me from manipulation, from control, from disrespect. There was always disrespect in my home, so that's the only thing I knew how to do was to defend myself. We made a decision that our children were not gonna see what he saw, what I saw.
If there's somebody out there and you say, man, I didn't have a father, he didn't teach me how to be a man, I'm telling you, you need to have a relationship with your father. You need to have a relationship with God Almighty. I'm telling you, I'm a witness of what a man should be because God did it in my life. He changed me. God has a plan for you. When you become a man, God is gonna give you the perfect wife. If you want a wife, work on your relationship with him first, and he will give you everything that you want.
A little over a year ago, I had foot surgery for the doctor to remove my arthritic bone and replace it with metal.
One day I was watching you a few months ago and you said to reach out, those of you at home, just reach out and touch the TV screen. And I said, this is crazy. Who ever heard of turning the metal into bone?
And because I had so much pain and swelling and couldn't hardly walk, I was on a walker, couldn't wear regular shoes, couldn't stand on my toes, couldn't run normally like I used to.
I had surgery and they removed my bone, replaced it with a metal rod, and my foot was swollen. I couldn't
for
get on my toe for a whole year. And I just got tired of that pain. But I said, I'm just gonna believe God and just, I'm tired of foot pain and swelling, and it was real sensitive. I couldn't touch, I couldn't wear shoes, and I just believe God. And every now and then, I go and rub that spot, and it's the same size as my other foot. I can wear shoes now. God heal me. He put bone there. I can't help but believe it.
Those of you who have that same type of metal, the same type of operation in your body, I challenge you to step out on faith and believe that God can heal you, that God will heal you, and that he is able to do exceedingly abundantly all that you will ask or think.
What you don't believe in the supernatural will do when a pestilence, an epidemic infection comes. What are they gonna do if you don't believe in the supernatural? The only way you're going to live is living in the supernatural and the power of God. Number six, earthquakes in diverse places. Did you know that in the 40s and 50s, we had earthquakes every 10 years? And then in the 70s and the 80s, every 5 years, every year. Now it's almost every day. It's almost every day. Number seven, persecution to the church. 24:9, and they will deliver you up to tribulation and kill you, and will be hated by all nations for my name's sake. A person that kill a Christian must be crazy. I mean, a person that kill a Christian, you must be deceived to kill somebody. And they think they will do it in the name of God. Lawlessness. Number 8, 24:12. And because lawlessness will abound, the love of many will grow cold. Lawlessness. What is lawlessness? Very simple. Rebellion. Do you want to know what the spirit of the age? The spirit of the age is rebellion. No one wants to submit to anybody. Even in church, they fight. They don't submit. They don't submit to anybody. They don't want to be accountable to anybody. Let me tell you, if you operate in the spirit of rebellion, that's the spirit of the Antichrist. That's the spirit of the age. And what's the spirit of the age? The Antichrist spirit, which is two things. Number one is against God or the things of God. And number two is in place of or in replacements of. Meaning what? When the spirit of Antichrist comes to the church and then he can fight the church face to face, he has to do a replacement. And that's why you see many replacements, substitutes on the church. That's the Antichrist spirit. That's the end. Number 9, the love of many wax cold. I don't go to church because they hurt me. I don't open my heart to anybody because they hurt me. I don't give money in the church because the pastor, oh, pastor, stole my money. And then people, the love wax cold because they were hurt. Is that an excuse? No. Forgive. Be cleansed with the blood of Jesus. Otherwise, you're going to stay. If Jesus come back tomorrow with unforgiveness, you're not going to go with Jesus. Number 10, many will be offended. 24:10. Many will be offended. What's the root of offense? Why people get offended? Why? Because of immaturity. The root of an offense, a person that get offended. Somebody say, yeah, pastor, but they really hurt me. Well, you can be righteously offended or unrighteously offended. But God said, listen, the end time, one of the signs of the end time is the offense. People will be easily offended. Hey, who gave you the money that you have, my brother? Don't get offended. That's the end time. That's the sign of the end time. Mature, shake it up, forgive, bless the people, and keep giving into the kingdom of God. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Come on. Sign number 11. Those 10 signs of the end time I just read to you. This is what Matthew says. Now let's go into our other books like Daniel and Luke mention number 11, the increase of knowledge and technology. That will be at the end time sign. Daniel chapter 12 verse 4, God said to Daniel, Daniel, shut up the words and seal the book until the time of the end. Many shall run and to and fro, and knowledge shall increase. In other words, he said, Daniel, this prophecy is for the end. And when did you see that sign came to pass? When Israel became nation. The latest an explosion of technology was when Israel became a nation. God is giving you Facebook, Superbook, Triple Book. God is giving you television, radio, Twitter, Instagram, not for you selfie. He has given you to preach the gospel of the kingdom. Why that sign already came to pass? Matthew 24:14, and when you see this gospel of the kingdom, the gospel of the kingdom is the gospel of power. Whenever you see that gospel, put your testimony in Twitter, put your testimony in Facebook, put your testimony, tell the people what God set you free from. Come on, stop your selfie and get Jesus selfie. Put it in Instagram. talk about Jesus. Technology is only for the preaching of the gospel of power with miracle, sign, and wonders.
We hope you were blessed by today's message and would like to further empower you by offering the series, The Revelation of the Second Coming of Christ. As you watch this latest series from Apostle Maldonado, you'll discover the truths behind the signs of the end times and learn how to prepare spiritually for His coming. You will also be activated to move in miracles, signs, and wonders to ready others for the second coming of Christ with a sense of urgency. This special edition 2-DVD offer is available for a limited time. The Revelation of the Second Coming of Christ. Call now and get your copies today.
I believe the Lord has been speaking to your life. I don't want to close this program without giving you an opportunity for you to receive Jesus as your personal Savior. Are you going through crisis? Are you going through problems in your marriage, in your health? Are you in depression and you don't find any way out? Jesus is the answer. The Bible says that we all sinners, we sinned against God. The wages of sin are death, but the gift of God is eternal life. If you're right now watching, if you're saying, can you pray for me? I'd like to pray for you. I want you to repeat this prayer out loud, wherever you are, if you're in your house, if you are watching television, if you're doing anything now, I want you to stop for a moment and I want you to just pray with me. Say, Father God, I recognize that I am a sinner. I repent of all my sins. I confess with my mouth that Jesus Christ is my Lord and my Savior. Jesus, come into my heart. And I believe with all my heart that Jesus Christ was raised from the dead. Thank you, Lord. Amen. And amen. If you did this prayer, I want you to call me and let me know Jesus came into your heart. God bless you.
Completely healed.
Atheists are coming. They're saying, I cannot believe what I just saw.
Drug addicts coming and receiving God.
As I was praying, the lumps and the scars disappeared.
It's the best experience of my life. The best weekend ever.
Thank you for sowing in this ministry. This ministry is bringing the supernatural power in many continents of the earth, and it's touching many lives. People are being changed, delivered, saved. And my gratitude to you because of your support, I'm sending you my book, Leaders That Conquer. You can download it right now in your computer. And this will bless you greatly. Thank you for your support. Financially, with your prayers, helping me to take the supernatural power to this generation. God bless you.
Thank you for watching today's program. If you want to learn more on how to accelerate and enable you to experience the supernatural in your life, contact us today. Join us next time as we see more of the supernatural now.